it takes courage to do something new, but also yes. takes courage to humble yourself and say, hey, I have a lot of experience, but in this place, I know those skills can be transferable. How can I help and how can you help me?
Oh, I love it. I'm highlighting courage, humility, but also emotions, being okay with being human in the midst of these pursuits. I'm just very much into that. I fear God deeply. I believe God is wondrous, mystical. Signs and wonders and miracles are available, but we're also fully human, right? Mm-hmm. He wants us whole. You've gone through some of these dark alleys in probably actually around that time through the pandemic. So talk to me about some of that experience in relation to, like, how were you able to keep yourself whole? You guys have two dynamic daughters, one of which is flourishing at Hampton, I believe, right?
Yes, yes.
At Hampton, and another finishing up at Pingree.
Yep.
One of the best schools in the state of New Jersey. Really, like I said, paving the way in relation from goals, being unrelenting in faith. Mm-hmm. How did you have to endure? You know, your husband endured a mental health crisis that was unshakable, shook us all up. Because I was there for it. But how were you kept together? What was your, resolve? What was your resources that allowed you to be fully human and endure some of the hardest time of your life?
It comes down to one word. And I think this is something that maybe we don't really appreciate until we need to appreciate it. And that's relationships.
Mm.
And so, on every aspect, there was no way me as just one person could endure something like that on my own. So it was relationship. It was family. It was the friends. It was the community, right?
Yes.
It was number one, hands down, the church.
Yes.
All those relationships and everyone giving whatever they could, no matter how small or how big, helped make it through those 3 years.
Yeah.
At whatever time. And so, because there are so many different moving parts and the whole world is going through a crisis. So we have that crisis and another crisis on top of it, right? So also being cognizant of not pulling too much from other people because everyone's going through a crisis, right? Mm-hmm. Just mine might be a crisis times two, right?
Or times 10.
And then really, I think that's where I really just had to say, you know what? This is what I don't have. And I thought I really trusted God, but I had to learn a new way to trust and also to trust the folks that I looked up to, right? So like you, your wife, or close friends of ours, other folks, in the community.
Sure.
And I want to follow their answers because I believe that they have a clearer mind right now than I do with everything going on. And I want to follow and believe that it's going to be okay. And we're going to trust God through the process, whatever that looks like, right? Because also being someone who's such a planner and wanting to have everything mapped out, this was not a part of the plan ever.
Man, now you're talking.
Where did this come from?
Hey, man, it's nothing worse than when God crushes our calendar. It crushes our plan book, our planners. And when I say God, just the life circumstance of it, meaning like God and his sovereignty for the people who believe in that paradigm, obviously us. So, we obviously walked through some painful moments, but you're talking about fears, like deep fears. And I tell people trust is the highest form of worship. Mm-hmm. I stated that recently. It's the highest form of worship because you won't know when you have to trust God until the moment comes, right? It's kind of like being in the ocean with the hope, faith, and belief that somebody's going to come. I'm still swimming. I'm still paddling.
And I'll never forget that. I remember maybe right before we knew that my husband was sick, and I had asked you, I said, it's like being in the boat. You said that same analogy about, trusting God, and it's like you're in the water and you just can't take over the boat. You have to let the boat go where God is going. I'm like, well, what if the boat is drowning? What do you do? Like, you don't try to, he was like, no, you just let it drown. Mm-hmm. And that is something that stuck with me. And I'm like, what?
Mm-hmm.
Like, how do you do that? How do you not try to save yourself? Yeah. Right. And I think for me, the biggest learning point in that whole process was at the end, when I finally stopped trying to save myself, is when God came in and came and swept and the boat got to shore. But it's so hard as a human to not save yourself.
There you go right there.
I think that's like the hardest thing.
No, that's truly the gem. But you know, and now you go through this metamorphosis. You go through this realization that he is, right? That he is the I am, whatever you need him to be. I had to kind of like give you that space to highlight that kind of growth, transformational growth that only painful things, only suffering can kind of bring out of it. But on the brighter side of your journey and pedigree, there's just so much inherent value in you in particular. Like, what do you enjoy doing? You have a lot of skills. Like, okay, so
what's my hobby? Shopping.
No surprise.
Everybody, I think, that knows me knows that.
That's true. Okay, so those are some of the more relief. I really enjoy this. But even from a skill set, like from a contribution standpoint, you have a lot of fleshed out skill deliverables, even like I said, personally and professionally. What is the one like that you actually like? You build the computers as a teenager, right? Like, I mean, not to say that that's something to do today, but like, what do you actually enjoy doing the most, even in relation when every day it goes to work?
I just think I like helping people make their dreams become a reality. So I think, you know, I love supporting the underdog. Like, oh, they said you couldn't do it. Now let's do it. Let's show them we're going to do it and do it better, you know? Yeah. And so that's how I think I interact with pretty much my clients. They have an idea. Ooh, can we do this? Can we do that? I'm like, ooh, let's do that. Okay. How does that sound? How would that look? I'm like, ooh, I don't know. Let's see how we can get it done, because that keeps the creativity, I think, in the type of work that I do. But I also like seeing other people succeed. I was always kind of a team, you know, player. Yeah. And I think when you ask the original question, what has changed from the way I operated before? I think now I have the opportunity really to do more collaborations with folks in business versus just being so self-focused. Nice. As an independent advisor, now I'm able to help folks do what I know has been successful for the past 2 decades.